What's up, what's going on? My name is Sabrina and I help women get healthy and heal from within. So if that's something that you like, make sure to subscribe and hit the bell so you don't miss any of the new videos. And today I want to share with you 12 tips that has helped me drastically reduce my sugar intake. So let's get right into it. So number one is to make sure to have your 6 days in most of your meals. And that's something that I share in another video that I will link above. It's called How to Get Rid of Sugar Cravings. And I dive deeper into the 6 days and how you can start integrating all of these days in your meals so you can get rid of sugar cravings. So for this case, the 6 days is the sweet taste, sour, salty, pungent, bitter, and astringent. And once you have all of these 6 days in most of your meals, you will feel plenty nourished and you will feel really satisfied. So you won't be craving sugar or wanting to grab anything sugary in the afternoons, let's say at around 3 o'clock in the afternoon. So make sure to have all of these 6 days in your meals. And again, I do dive deeper into this in another video. So number two is to drink warm water throughout the whole day. And I insist on drinking warm water instead of cold water because the body thrives on warmth. So stick to herbal teas or maybe some warm lemon ginger water, something that will keep you really warm and hydrated throughout the whole day. So yeah, instead of wanting to grab something, maybe you think you are hungry or something, but you are actually probably dehydrated. So yeah, stick to drinking warm water throughout the day and you will see that you will feel less tempted to grab sugar sweet stuff. Number three is if you feel dehydrated, but you also want something a little bit sweeter on the side, is to have a sweet tea, a sweet herbal tea. And my favorite one is licorice tea. I think it has a lot of nourishing sweetness to it and it is really satisfying. So just make sure to drink this in moderation. And yeah, some sweet licorice tea. I like to buy the ones that have a lot of different spices in there, like cinnamon and sometimes some cloves. And there's just a bunch of different spices mixed in with the licorice tea. And you will feel that you will less be tempted to grab something sweet when you have a sweet beverage like this one. Number four is to drink a hot cocoa drink. And I really like the one from Four Sigmatic because they add a little bit of healing mushrooms in there. And it is just really grounding and it has no sugar in there. It is really, really good and really satisfying for the sweet taste. So I will put a link down below from this company. And yeah, I really love to have one of these once in a while. And it has a lot of really grounding and chilling properties to it. So number five is to make sure to eat enough grounding and nourishing foods. So if you are only eating lots of salads and you're probably skipping meals and you're just not eating on a regular schedule, your body will definitely crave the sweet taste, which is, you know, from the 6 tastes that I talked to earlier, your body will definitely crave the sweet taste. And all of the sweet foods are more like rice, quinoa, whole wheat, meat, oils, and seeds. All of these really grounding and nourishing foods that really gives you most of your energy for the day is definitely something your body will crave if you are not eating enough or if you are eating too much of the lighter foods like salads or even if you are skipping too many meals. So make sure to have enough grounding foods like sweet potatoes and rice, quinoa, and that you feel really full and satisfied for your every meals. Otherwise, you will definitely be craving a lot of sugar, which is definitely more grounding to the body. Number six is to make sure to make your sleep a priority. And I'm sure you've noticed this for yourself as well, is if you don't sleep enough, you will be craving a lot of sugar the next day. So for me, I always make sure to sleep at least 7 to 9 hours sometimes. And this just makes me want to stick a little bit more to my healthier choices, my healthier food choices, and wanting to stick to my regular eating times for having my meals. So try to make your sleep a priority. This will definitely help with your sugar cravings and sugar intake. And if you have trouble with your sleep, I do have a whole playlist where I guide you through my healing practices that you can do to make sleep more of a priority and making it easier to go to sleep and fall asleep way faster. So number seven is to change up your sweeteners at home. And that's something that we've talked a lot about in the health and wellness industry in the past few years, is to get rid of all of the artificial sweeteners and just white sugar in general, all things processed like this, and switch it up for more natural whole kind of sweeteners. So that would be like maple syrup, honey, and king sugar. These are my three favorite ones that I like to use. And also you will be tempted to use a little bit less because they are definitely sweeter and more whole for the body. So you will be using a little bit less of these natural, wholesome kind of sweeteners instead of doing the processed ones. Number 8 is if you feel like you're not dehydrated and you still feel hungry and you still feel also like you want something sweet, is to have warm milk with a little bit of cinnamon in there and honey. Cinnamon and honey are definitely going to kick your sugar craving and will definitely help make you feel a little bit more nourished and grounding, because that's something that your body is definitely craving at this time when you crave sweet taste. So I just like to warm up a little bit of milk in there, and you can go for nut milk or wholesome, you know, cow's milk, whatever's milk you got on hand will do, and add just maybe half a teaspoon of cinnamon powder, and also half a teaspoon of honey is good as well. So drink this maybe in the afternoon if you feel like your sugar craving is kicking in, and you'll feel definitely more nourished and satisfied with this. Number 9 is to make sure to have a big lunch and also a breakfast. If you tend to skip breakfast sometimes, you will probably be craving a little bit sugar in the afternoon and want to grab some snacks here and there. So if you can make your regular meal times a routine, that will definitely help with your cravings around sugar and wanting to eat a little bit more sugar throughout the day. Number 10 is something that I would suggest if you go through all of these tips and you still feel like you cannot get rid of your sugar cravings and you still want to always grab your sweet stuff and the baked stuff, is to have an Ayurvedic herb in terms of like a tea. So you would definitely steep this herb. It is really, really bitter, so it doesn't taste good. And I've tried it out for myself because a few years ago, I really had a hard time letting go from my sugar addiction. So I bought this herb. It's called Gymnema sylvester leaves. And yeah, because it is really bitter, it'll definitely just restart your taste buds, and bitter taste really kicks in for this sweet taste and will definitely get rid of your sugar cravings at this time if you drink this. So I would steep this in hot water and drink this whenever you feel like you've got a really big sugar craving and you want to get rid of this, you can have this herb. So number 11 is a more of a like spiritual emotional part of this sugar craving thing, and why we want to grab sugar in the first place, is because when we lack quality in our life, in this case, if we like sweetness in our life, we will definitely want to grab something sweet to eat instead. So ask yourself, where in life are you lacking sweetness? Maybe you lack sweetness from a love relationship. Maybe you lack sweetness like a touch from someone. Maybe you lack sweetness in your job. Maybe you don't like your day-to-day routine. Ask yourself where you do lack this sweetness in your life, and you will be less tempted to grab some sweet stuff afterwards. Number 12, my last tip, is how can you feel a little bit more grounded in your body and your day-to-day life? Because when we crave sweetness, we crave groundness, we crave heaviness in the body, and a great way to increase this quality in our body is through different grounding practices. So that could be with grounding elements like earth and water elements. So by earth, you can go for a walk in nature, maybe have your feet on the grass, maybe you can just play in the mud. Just working a little bit with the earth element is really, really grounding. And if you want to work with the water element, that would be taking a bath, a warm shower, going to the spa. Anything that is related to the water will definitely help. And also having a grounding or restorative yoga practice is really grounding for the body as well. So if you can increase your grounding practices, this will definitely help reduce your sugar intake in the long run. So that's it for me. I hope this was valuable, and if so, make sure to give a big thumbs up, like, comment, subscribe, and also if you found this valuable, make sure to share this video to someone that with someone that could need a little bit of help in terms of reducing their sugar intake. And until then, I'll see you in the next video.